Welcome to the Vector Garden. In this video, we're going to take a look at the new features in Illustrator's Dimension tool in the update version 28.3. So I have drawn these figures. These are just two lines that cross, and it's just one path. And then let's take the Dimension tool. We get the pop-up, we get those three modes of operation, so linear, angular, and we have the radial dimension. And then, of course, we have the options in here. And in here, let's set the precision to 0 for a start. We can set this to the document unit, and then I have set up some colorings for the dimension lines and the extension lines. And then I have set up the font and styling for the text, like this. Okay, so then let's get this to work. First of all, to get the document unit, you can make a right click into the ruler and then set that unit in here. So it's millimeters for me. And then in order to take the measurement, I'm going to take a linear measurement just by pressing the Alt key and clicking on this figure. And then I get the width and height of this object. And then let's get to the angular dimension. And to get that, you can just click on that corner point and get this into there. And this is very tight, and maybe it doesn't look too well, so let's undo that. You can also click and drag and position that to here or the like. I have just drawn this element, and it's not likely that it has an angle of exactly 106 degrees. So let's undo that again, and I'm going to open the options. And of course, when you set a different precision, then do that again. So let's click and drag, and you see we get a more precise value, which is far more likely that it's this angle. What you also see is the angular dimensions also have extension lines, which are there. And we can see them because they are yellow now. So in order to make this angular dimension, you can also, and it's needed for this figure, you need to show Illustrator which angle you want to get in this figure. So you have to click on here, and then you see a very faint line. Now it's important now, if you now realize that you do not want to do that, you can't undo it just now. You could press Escape and then you're out of it, but you cannot undo. You can only undo it once you have created an actual visible dimension. So let's start again. I'm going to click here and then click here, and then you can drag or drag here to see which one you want to get, and then when you have figured it out, then just click again and you get this dimension. What we have got now is we can see that in the layers panel we have got a layer of dimensions, and Illustrator has created everything on that. All these actually don't belong there, they have been moved up there. So Illustrator creates this layer for the dimensions and then automatically puts the dimensions onto it, but the layer is not locked, so you can also draw on it. Now we're going to watch this. I'm going to put it to the side. What's new now is that you can change this. So if you move it, then you see the dimension moves as well. So we are not changing the angle here, but we could do that as well. So I could move just this anchor point, and then you see it gets a different angle and Illustrator adjusts. The same happens here. and you see all the dimension lines adjust to that new dimension. This also works when you do it like this, using the bounding box, and you see this adjusts as well, so the dimension lines move with it. The dimension lines can also be selected like this, and then you see in the control panel they are named as dimension lines, and you can change their attributes. For instance, I could change the color here, and you see the color has been adjusted, but only for the one I have selected. And then, of course, you can select a different font for the text. Let's make something really different. So I'm going for Eurostyle, and you see it has been changed. But this is not everything you can do. If we go to the Properties panel and go in here, then you see you can change a lot more, and you can do that without having to open the options. You can just go in here and change that, and also you can apply it to all. So in here I could apply that to all, and then you see all the colors have been changed now to what I have selected in there. And that is very nice that this happens. What doesn't happen, and we're going into the preferences for that, so I'm going to Illustrator Preferences General. On Windows you find that in Edit. And then the Use Preview Bounds options. So it's set at the moment. And let's also go in here and let's see what happens. So I make a much thicker stroke, but then the dimension lines do not adjust to that. So what we can do now is, you know, press the Alt key and create a new set of dimension lines, and then you see they are different, but the existing ones did not adjust to that change of line width. So that's kind of important. It can be, a lot of things can be adjusted, but just not that. We have another important thing about changing stuff later on. So these two are very close together. Now, what if I want to change the distance of those dimension lines later on? Now, that depends on how you select them. So let's first take the selection tool, and then I just want to move it. So I'm going to select it. You see it's selected, the text is selected. And in the Layers panel, you can also see it selected. But what you also see, it's now, it's one object, it's a live object. So now I'm going to move that, pressing the Shift key to move it horizontally. And you already see the warning on the top, Dimension Object Expanded. And then you can also see in the Layers panel, that is no longer a live object, it's now been expanded, and we have the single paths. So that's not very desirable, because then, of course, when you later on adjust the object, then the dimension line will not change anymore. So let's undo that. And it's now a live object again. And when you want to change that, you need to use the dimension tool. And it also doesn't matter which one of its modes you use. You have a linear dimension line here, and if you use the angular mode, that doesn't matter. So let's move that. And you see, I do not even need to press the Shift key. I can just drag that. And what happens is, number one, it doesn't get expanded, but also we get longer extension lines. So it's a life change. It changes kind of the options of this, so it has just different distances, and we get those, you know, those distance wider so that we can read the values.